Hi, everyone. This is my honor to share some considerations about the communication and connectivity for autonomous vehicles. In my point of view, I think that connectivity brings some new characters to autonomous driving. First of all, the collection based on cellular network makes the system possible to keep growing by the software update and the data collection. And the second one, the second character, the cooperation between vehicle and infrastructures extends the service to the vehicle and even make the autonomous vehicle more intelligent. The collection made via cellular communication or C-V2X communication. And the third one is the enhanced safety by cooperation between vehicles. Definitely, via the robust and the low latency dedicated communication. Then I would like to share some view or points about these new characters and some practice of Changan Automobile in the following slides. The first character introduced by the collectivity is growth. There are some reasons and motivations. First of all, it's one of the users' requirements. The users, especially the young generation customers, they expect to have the same experience as smartphone in the intelligent autonomous vehicle. They expect the software can update it. They expect the post-purchase feature enhancement is available. They expect the system become more and more robust. So this is the one reason. And the second reason, the second motivation is from the OEM. The OEMs want to create more values from the same hardware platform, which is expensive with big computing power. Take Changan's car as example. The price of vehicle models is ranged from $18,000 to $23,000. As the level two plus autonomous system will take around 10% to 20% of the cost. So we are trying to create the technical possibility to add more features based on the same cameras, based on the same domain controllers. We are exploring some new business models to earn money from this system. So we want the system can grow, we can earn money from these new features. The third reason, in my opinion, is a high-level autonomous technology is not that mature. Now, we even say that it's a high-level autonomous driving system, but it's still it's kind of driving assistance, very advanced driving assistance system in the vehicle. So this technology will take the time and the date to be mature. So this is the reason we think why we want this vehicle, this system, keeping growing up. And to support this type of autonomous driving system, of course, the software can be updated. The HD map or ADAS map can be updated. And the configuration information can be loaded into ECUs. One special thing for autonomous driving system is that there are a few associated ECUs in this system. Between these ECUs, the signals are exchanged. When a new feature is enhanced or updated, the associated ECU should be updated in the same time. To be more specific, when you enhance the autonomous driving features through over the air, you may update the software of the autonomous driving domain controller, the smart sensors, the gateway, the infotainment system, the instrument cluster in the same time. So this makes the system level solution very complicated, and also the size of the software package is large. Furthermore, in terms of the development methods for an autonomous driving system, data-driven development is the trend. The data of the EDR, the vehicle working status, driving habits, raw data of the sensors, and et cetera, is collected to develop new features to improve the performance of the existing autonomous system. to validate the system. According to our estimation, for our next generation autonomous vehicle, in the early stage, that's around 10 gigabytes data will be collected to the cloud. So this is the amazing size of the volume of the data. So we are thinking to achieve such kind of feature, that low latency, high bandwidth cellular communication is a foundation, and the amazing data volume should be supported by new business models. Next slide, please. So according to Changan's practice, there are some points I would like to share with you. First, our first step is the one to our, all of our vehicles to be collected. So by 2020, all Changan's vehicles are networked, no longer produce long collected vehicles. This is the first point. And the second one, we found that the external network like the 4G, 5G can be our requirement. However, our bottleneck is the internal network and the E architecture. Why? Because we, in our vehicle models, we keep a few variants of each vehicle models, the low level, mid level, high level, and even more variants. So the E architecture is kind of distributed and some kind of integrated type, but not the centralized or zonal type. So it's more challenging to have the vehicle-wise software updated or data collection. Next slide, please. Then the second character is a service extension based on the V2I. So which scenarios should be, our point is that the more complicated the road conditions are, the more V2I based service is needed. Why? It's because that we're thinking that in the simple scenarios, the direct, the active sensors can make a good effect, but in the complicated the scenarios, the communication can help a lot. So in our point of view, we think that we had better to deploy the V2I service to parking areas first, then to urban, then to highway. This is also the point we proposed to the Chinese government. Now, Chinese government have been promoting a few pilot projects on highway and the city area already. For example, China's longest and the most complicated intelligent highway will be completed in 2021. It is around 128 kilometers and 47% are tunnels and bridges. And there will be more than 300 ISU will be equipped. And there are more than 10 cities in China. They have the demonstration areas for the smart road and the collectivity for the test for the collectivity car. And a few enterprises had some demos in parking areas to provide the demos like the reservation for a parking slot or the map distribution. So this is the kind of status in China. Next slide, please. And what Changan have done first is that we build up our smart campers and not the build up, we just modify our campers to a smart campers and the parking slots in our R&D center to be a smart to be collected. They have more than 80 smart RSU has been equipped in our campers and the parking slots. And we join in the demonstration activity of L4 level road intelligent vehicles and other demonstration in China. Next slide, please. The third character is enhanced safety by cooperation. In our concept is that if we want to talking about if the autonomous vehicle, the high level autonomous vehicle can drive better than human being, that the communication is indispensable because it has the capability to sense the long line of sight scenarios. So if we are aiming at the autonomous driving in all conditions, the communication is necessary. According to a public publication from Waymo, now we can see a few collision and minor contact events in automated driving tests are published. So there are, in this slide, there are three examples here. We can see that all these scenarios can be really covered by the sensors, like LiDARs, cameras are used on Waymo's autonomous automated car. Even it's already a kind of high level of autonomous vehicle. So we still think that if we want to get this kind of enhanced safety, with the communication, the V2V application should be deployed. The next slide, please. Because the V2V standard has not been really released in China, so in the past 10 years, the Changan lead or participant a few of the Chinese government funding projects trying to have some research and development activities in collected automated vehicle areas. And we also join and lead some of the to establishing some Chinese national industry standards. And we also have developed the 13 V2X applications in-house. This is what we have done in the past. Next slide. This slide is also the last slide. So when we're talking about these three characters, we want to know when we can see those new characters in production vehicles. So my point of view is that I'm thinking that we can see the character of growth very soon because the OEMs have enough motivations. They will make their car to be very open to be collected and have the better e-architecture. It will be a very popular character in most of the new production cars in the next 2 years. This is my point of view. And for the V2I service, I think this is be leading or driven by the government at this moment, like in China. So because the Chinese government, they want to advance its transportation to digitalization and the use of the artificial intelligence. And the government would like to invest for the infrastructure. So my estimation is that around 2023 to 2025, that we will see some real production in the market. But for the V2V, the enhanced safety, my point of view is not that optimistic because it will be driven by the industry. So I'm thinking that if we will see the real production, the massive production, that will be after 2025. That's my view. Okay, that's all my the points I would like to share with you. Thank you.